Hello, dear participants. This is a quick introduction to the Green ePortfolio as part of your longer Green Jobs certification program. And quickly explain what the second phase basically means for you. You all have access to the eCampus and the online learning platform, where by now you have almost finalized your assignments. Well, if you just go there, you will see that there's now a button activated with Green ePortfolio. And if you click on it, you basically arrive in the Green ePortfolio. And what I want to do now is to explain a bit what we're going to do in the upcoming months. You will continue to engage in learning about green jobs, mainly in the field of your own work, in the projects that you're involved, and other green jobs learning opportunities that are out there. And that's the four building blocks what I'm going to explain right now. The first block is a reflection block. And we ask you now, well, in your wider environment, what kind of green jobs learning opportunities are out there and which could be used to document the evidence in this green e-portfolio. So first of all, write down your kind of expectations in this field. Also, what further skills and knowledge do you want to built based on already the standard knowledge that you have, and maybe also maybe prioritize in terms of, let's say, short-term goals and long-term goals. This is a quick reflection that we make before you start to fill in the e-portfolio. How can you fill it in? You click always on the edit button. And once you have clicked on the edit button, you will see that there are little wheels here. These are configuration wheels. If you click on them, you will see a window that pops up with what you see is what you get editor. So it's as simple as a Word editor. You fill in your expectations and you click on save. And you do exactly the same for the skills and knowledge and the goals. And once you've done, you click on done. It brings you always back to the dashboard. And on the dashboard, you say we can move towards the second block, which is about the courses that you're going to follow. You already did an introduction course in the online course, but there might be other courses that you will follow in these years. So what we would like to focus on now is which courses did you follow? There might be some distance learning courses and some face-to-face courses. You just need to indicate here in the distance learning part and the face-to-face part which courses you have attended or which courses you still need to attend. Same mechanism, you always click on edit here, and once you have clicked on edit, you just go on the configuration wheel and you actually write down the distance learning course or the face-to-face course, and maybe combine it with some key learning insights, because that's also very useful for your tutor that you're going to get to also communicate into a dialogue with him or her. Once you have done that, always click on done and it brings you to the dashboard again. The third column is one of the most important ones. It's where we are going to document further learning evidence. You're busy with a project that is connected with Green Jobs. You have a learning opportunity identified in your larger working environment. And here we're going to ask you to produce specific outputs. You have already completed the final assignment, but we think there might be additional professional evidence on Green Jobs learning out there. That might be an article, that might be the delivery of a training course, it might be a larger TC project that you're involved in. Anything is fit for purpose. What we ask you to do is at least select a number of these activities, and you will see that each activity, whether it's in the knowledge research branch or in the capacity development branch or in the more project program related branch, each activity has a number of credits. The only thing you need to do is build up your credits up to a minimum of 15 points. Imagine you deliver the training course in Green Jobs to your constituents, that's already 7 points. You upload some training related material that you have developed for that, that's an additional 3 points. And maybe you also published an article on it, that's an additional 5 points. And that's basically enough to reach the minimum credit. You're always invited to do more, but the minimum is at least 15. This evidence you need to summarize and you need to upload it. How do I upload? Again, I click on edit. Once you've clicked on edit, you go here to upload your evidence. When you click on the manage button, you will see that you're allowed to actually choose your files, and that can be a PowerPoint, it can be a PDF, it can be a Word document. You basically just upload it and you also save it. And once it's saved, it will appear here. In case there are videos, you need to use the other field here, which is indicated at the back of the page. So that's it in a nutshell. Try to find as much evidence as possible. You need to be personally involved. You cannot just copy paste the training course from someone else. For the tutor, it needs to be evident that it's a product, a service that you have actually run and that you were responsible for. That's very important, because the Green ePortfolio is a personal portfolio upon which your tutor will give you feedback and comment upon. Then it brings me back to the dashboard, and the last field is a short learning repository, which we ask you to upload three interesting articles that you have found in the upcoming months on Green Jobs, three interesting videos to watch, as the world is full of video and audiovisual material, and then maybe also three interesting links. This will actually also contribute to the larger Green Jobs repository that we are currently building. So it's as simple as that. You have the dashboard, you have four different blocks, you reflect, you mention which courses you have participated with or you're going to participate, you actually upload the learning evidence of other activities that you were involved with, and you add some learning materials or some resources to the learning repository. This is, let's say, the simple structure. Of course, you will see, if I go to the ePortfolio, that they're more things. For example, you could actually make your profile a little bit more, so it becomes like a kind of a personal curriculum vitae, which you can also share with tutors and others. You will see different blocks. You could actually add some plans and notes, but let me clarify, these are optional ones. The most important ones are the four standard building blocks. The portfolio is actually something personal, but you can also share it with other pieces. So actually I can share, and if I click on the share button, you will see that you can grant access to other people. You just edit the access here, and then you can actually add some friends here in the project. If you have issues with that, just contact us and we will help you along. So we will see that there are more buttons there than we actually use, but I would say for the time being this is an introduction. You just use the four major building blocks. You can eventually share it with some other people, and you can actually upgrade your profile. That's it as for now. We will produce more materials that can support you. The first important thing is that you quickly explore the portfolio, that you quickly test how you can edit and change things, and once you have done that, you know where you have to upload your portfolio. For us, this is going to be a very important collection resource, where we have access to a database of all different Green Jobs learning experiences. So give access to each other. Hope you learn a lot. Hope we collect a lot, and we will follow up on this with more news later. Thank you.